Good evening, folks. You're listening to the Justinio Reads podcast. Thank you so much for tuning in, and enjoy the show. Mr. Frostee. I live in an urban neighborhood community. Every night, there's an ice cream truck that drives by my house. It plays the same Pop Goes the Weasel song and is never late for its 10 p.m. arrival. Who the hell drives an ice cream truck at 10 o'clock at night? I used to ask myself. But it happened. Every night without fail. 10 p.m. on the dot. This polka dot, windowless van comes rolling down our street, playing exactly at the same part of Pop Goes the Weasel every single night. One night, as I was putting away dishes, I heard the truck coming again. So I opened my door to peer outside. Slowly appearing over the top of the hill on our street, there it was. Headlights already on due to the hour. I decide to go ahead and walk out into my yard to get a closer look. As the van approached my house, I noticed there was a clown's head on the driver's side roof. Typical red, curly hair, wearing a comically tiny top hat offset from the center of its balding head. Its head was tilted back, staring at the sky, its mouth hanging open as it wobbled and spun around loosely as the van slowly rolled through the neighborhood. The van was no more than two houses down when I stepped onto my curb and waved them over. As the van approached my curb, it sputtered and popped as the vehicle rolled to a complete stop, and the music droned to a stop as well. That sounded disturbing, I thought. Then again, everything about this van was off. The windows were tinted black. I couldn't see in. I glanced to my right and began to look at the menu on the side of the van. Mr. Frostee, it said. There were your typical rainbow rocket pops, Mickey Mouse and SpongeBob popsicles with the gumball eyes, and the chocolate chip covered ice cream cones. But there was also a badly drawn clown, both hands out, miming as if he were holding the popsicle stickers floating above his gloved hands, like the lady that spun the letters around on Wheel of Fortune. Its face in a giant toothy grin, and its eyes wide open in a dead stare. How is this supposed to be appealing to little kids? I thought. Just then, I heard what sounded like a latch lifting from inside the van, and the side door slid open. The light inside was dim, lit only by an old light bulb dangling in the middle of the van, giving off an orange, dim glow. The figure of a man in a red and white candy striper suit leaned over the counter, his gloved hands resting across the counter in a wide stance.
"So, what'll it be?"
the man said. An aroma of lit cigar wafted through the air as the man leaned in toward me. Sure enough, balanced on his lip was a freshly lit cigar. The man looked to be in his 40s. He had dark, scraggly hair and was wearing a clown nose on his face and a small bowler hat too small for his head. "Hey, I don't think your boss would enjoy you smoking in a company van around kids." The man raised an amused eyebrow and cackled a hoarse laugh.
"Boss? I am the boss. I'm an independent contractor, kid. Now, do you want something or not?"
he said, tapping his cigar, ashes going all over the counter.
I'll take a Mickey Mouse popsicle," I said.
Without saying anything, the man slumped away to the back of the dark van, and I waited. Looking down at my watch, I could see that about 3 minutes had passed. What's taking him so long? Maybe the old man needed better lighting for the inside of his creepy van? I stuck my head inside the side door and peered into the darkness that was the back of the van. There was an almost ear-ringing silence in the air. Just then, a loud, garbled laugh came from above the van. I jumped back, yelling, "Holy shit!" The laughing was coming from the clown head on top of the van, violently spinning and wobbling in circles, before fading off into a slow, warped tone, like a dying doll's voice box.
"What the hell?"
I yell. Just then, the man comes back, laughing.
"Sorry, kid. It does that sometimes. Here you go. That'll be $2.
I reached into my pocket and pull out a $5 bill.
You got change for a $5?
The man looks down at my bill, then back up at me. He is motionless, staring at me for what seemed too long. I couldn't see in the dim light the whites of his eyes. I noticed the man was now missing his clown nose. And did he have a mustache before? I couldn't remember. His suit was striped blue and white, but I remember it being red and white. I must just be tired. It's been a long day. Finally, he takes a breath, moves to grab my bill, and exclaims,
"Of course I do. One sec."
As he disappears once again to the back of the dark van. At this point, I'm thoroughly creeped out.
"This doesn't make any sense,"
I mutter to myself. I look down at my watch again. By this point, it is now 10:15, and I'm just standing there, waiting for my $3 and change.
"Sir?"
I yell to the back of the van. No response. I begin to open my Mickey Mouse popsicle while I wait. I'm looking around my street. No kids in sight at this hour. I'm getting to the second gumball eye, when I hear what sounded like a plastic bottle falling to the ground, bouncing around inside the van.
Sir?
I call out. No response.
Okay, this is starting to get really weird.
I say, finishing off my ice cream. I glance down at my watch again. But before I could read the time, something wet fell onto my arm. It was too dark to see what color it was, so I fumbled to get my phone's flashlight with my now popsicle-free hand. Upon closer inspection, it appeared to be a dark substance that smelled of iron.
Oh my God! It's blood!
I yell. Looking up, I see the clown head hanging over the edge of the van, eyes rolled back in its head. It was then that I realized it was a real human head. I'm frozen in fear, not believing what I'm looking at, when an arm from inside the van reaches out to grab me.
Let go of me!
I yell, both hands grabbing at the arm. I fall to the ground in a panic struggle when I realize I'm still holding the arm. It was that of a dummy, with a white glove fitted around its fingers. I quickly throw the arm back into the van and bolt back inside my house, locking my door behind me, and call the police. As I'm relaying my information to the dispatcher, I hear the droning sound of Pop Goes the Weasel begin to increase in pitch, and the revving of the van's engine as it speeds away, that clown laugh echoing off in the distance that will haunt me forever. I look out the window to the street and see a dark figure standing in the middle of the road. I unlatch and slide my window open to yell out,
"I've already called the police, buddy. Get out of here."
But the figure isn't moving. Making sure to relatch my window shut, I walk to my door and look through the peephole. It's hard to see with it being so dark out, so I flick on my porch light. Just then, I notice a clown's face staring back at me directly at the peephole.
Jesus!
I scream, jumping back. Taking a moment to catch my breath, I slowly approach the peephole again to observe what the hell I was looking at. The clown wasn't moving, but the top of the head looked unusually shiny, almost plastic. I slowly opened the door to what I now realize was a mannequin. The kind you'd see in your local mall. It was dressed in a blue and white candy striper uniform that reeked of cigar smoke, with a clown nose and a tiny bowler hat on its head. The eyes were solid black, and the right arm was missing. But in the gloved fingers of its left hand were three $1 bills. I yell outside,
"I don't know what kind of joke this is, but it isn't funny. The cops are on their way, and you can keep the change."
I then quickly close and lock the door. Never saw that mannequin, or Mr. Frostee, ever again. Hey everyone, this has been Justinio. Thank you for tuning in to the Justinio Reads podcast. If you enjoyed, be sure to tune in for the next episode, and have a great night.